Okay, hello friends, welcome back to Getting Yourself Organized with Org Mode, my little screencast about Org Mode. Today is Friday, day 5, episode 4, and we want to have a look at effort estimates. You remember two snippets ago, episode 4, snippet 3, was about clocking, that you measure your time that you take when you do a job. You see, we had a clocking table here, and then the next snippet was about column view, that we defined a column with clock sums, and now we define effort. Effort is just a property. There is a property named effort, and if we want to use it, the easiest way is, we could open a property drawer and type effort 30 minutes or whatever, but we can also define a property line here that is named effort all, and that holds all possible values for effort that we want to use. And then it's getting interesting, because we put a extra field on the columns line that you define a column for effort, and the definition is percentage 8, so 8 characters wide, effort, and then we have that parentheses and the colon and the other one, and this construct just means that this column holds time values. And that's hours and minutes separated by a colon, and this construct says sum them up. So let's go to column view that you see what I'm talking about, because I guess it's much easier if I show you than if I want to talk about it. So we are here on the examples headline, and we switch to column view, CXC. So you see, we still have those time measurements that we made, and now I have that extra column effort. And now if I want to assign an effort to task A, I just put the cursor in this column, and then I press shift and cursor right, and you see the first value is 5 minutes. That means I'm at 5 minutes, and if I want to go through those values, it's just shift cursor right, 10 minutes, 15, 20, 30, oh, that was too much, let's put it in 1 hour. So you see we have that effort estimate 1 hour for task A, and the sum for all examples is also 1 hour. We can do the same, we are still in column view, we give that task an effort estimate of 10 minutes. So you see, now in column view, I see all those children under examples have a summed up effort of 1 hour 10 minutes that I'm expecting that this will take. The very nice thing for this is, you remember 2 days ago when we talked about clocking, we said, okay, go on the task and press CXI to start the clock. And now you see a little bit different value down here, because you see the actual clock that says 9 minutes. You see 5 minutes, 3 minutes, 1 minute, it sums up to 9 minutes. And here on the right side of this slash, you see the effort that you have estimated. So now the clock is still below that effort, so you can work and it's everything fine. And just let's wait a bit. I guess in 1 minute this thing will change a bit. So it's 20:59, okay. Oh, let's see how long this will take until my 10 minutes are finished. But you see, the really easy thing is I can define all possible common effort things, and now you see we are at 10 minutes here, and the effort is 10, and the clocked time is getting a red background. That should indicate, hey, now you are practically at the limit of what you have estimated before. So you should come to an end, you should be finished. Okay, let's stop the clock, CXO. Now you see I'm at 11 minutes, I guess. Let's go back to column U, CXC. Now I'm still at 10. Yeah, 2, 3, 1. It's 11 minutes time and 10 minutes effort. That's just the way that you look, how good are my effort estimates. I mean, I was defining them 5 minutes, 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes, 30 minutes, then 1 hour. I could also set 45 minutes, whatever. And then I increase the distance even more, because I say if something would take more than 8 hours or whatever, then you should split it down to smaller tasks. And of course I can, no matter what, you can easily say, okay, this one should take 12 minutes. Let's quit this here and go back to the column view. Then you see I have an effort of 12 minutes. You can always edit it by hand, but if you want to step through predefined values, that's the easiest way. That was about efforts. But this column thing that you define properties with a property name and then underscore all value is also nice for other things. You remember our book collection where we have those books. I changed the line for the column view a bit. You see now I have a 7 characters wide rating column, and you see up here I have defined rating all. That means now if I'm looking at my books and I want to rate them, it's just column view CXC, and then I go to this rating column. Now it's not summing up at all, because you can't sum up ratings, but I can shift cursor right. You see, every time I press cursor right, I add to the rating that I defined up here. I could also use words like poor, medium, excellent, whatever. I just decided now I want to have 1 plus for one star or whatever, and 5 plus for a very good book, and of course I can rate them like that. And if you quit column view and you look inside the properties, then you see now I have a new property rating, and that's 5 pluses for that book. So that's practically another use of column view, that you can predefine values for your properties that you display, and you can switch through them just with shift cursor left or cursor right. And you can put effort estimates in, and this is even a thing that then your clocking shows you if you are below the effort that you have estimated or if you are above the effort. So that's all for today. Thanks for watching, thanks for all the comments, and this was the snippet, if I sum it up, 20. What I did now, so this weekend I have to go into brainstorming again to think what I can show you next week. Don't worry, I'll be back as usual. Have a nice weekend and enjoy working with org mode. I guess now you have learned a lot of concepts and you can really increase your productivity by just doing a small org mode file and doing what I showed you. Okay, thanks. And bye.